Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. Now in this video I want to try and explain some of the problems you might experience if you begin to use the rechargeable lithium ion batteries that are available now in AA and AAA sizes. They're not new to the market, they've been around for a while, but I've only just started to use them in an attempt to try and get some longer run times for some of the battery operated equipment that I use. That's in preference to using something like the NiCad or nickel metal hydride batteries that I've been currently using. These batteries have a output of 1.5 volts, so they're higher than the 1.2 or 1.3 nickel metal hydride or NiCad batteries. And they maintain their output right into the very point of discharge. So you can get a full 2000 milliamp hours out of these batteries and then they cut off completely. Unlike a traditional alkaline battery or the nickel metal hydrides, where you get a gentle decay, you can actually see when your torch is running dim or your indicator on your product shows that you are getting low in battery. With these type of batteries, you'll find there is no indication as to the status charge. They will continue at 1.5 output until the internal mechanism cuts off the lithium ion battery. And I'll explain more about how these work in just a moment. Well, you can see on screen now the batteries that I purchased. These are made by EBL. They have a dedicated charger. They won't charge in a standard charger. You need to use the special chargers. They came in at £20.99 on Amazon UK. So you get the four batteries and the charger for that £21. Now, if you look at the actual battery itself, one of the confusing issues is the fact that these are rated in milliwatt hours. So you can see there we got 3000 milliwatt hours or 3 watt hours. Traditionally, a NiCad or nickel metal hydride are rated at milliamp hours. So you'll find something like 2,500 milliamp hours on the side of the battery. So you can see on the EBL battery here, it's rated at 3,000 milliwatt hours. Here on a AA battery, you can see it's 1.2 volts. Minimum of 1900 milliamp hours. So when you're looking at these values, you think, oh, well, that's much higher capacity than this because this is only 1900 and this is 3000. What you have to do is a conversion from milliwatt hours to milliamps. And to do that, you divide the milliwatt hours by the battery voltage. And in this case, it's going to be 1.5. So you divide 3000 by 1.5 and you end up with a capacity of 2000 milliamp hours. So this 3000 milliwatt hours is actually the equivalent of 2000 milliamp hours. So these two batteries are roughly the same. So in the case of the EBL battery, you're going to be paying something like £4.50 for each cell compared to a pound or less for the NiCad or nickel metal hydride battery. So are you getting any benefit from it? Well, let's have a look at that later in the video. But in terms of capacity, they're roughly the same. Okay, the nickel metal hydride or NiCad battery will only have an output of 1.2 volts, where the lithium battery is designed to give an output of 1.5, the same as a traditional zinc chloride or alkaline battery. When you look at these cells, they are exactly the same profile as a standard AA or AAA battery, and they are nominally 1.5 output. To achieve that 1.5 output, they are employing a buck converter to convert the 3.7 nominal output voltage of the lithium ion core cell in here down to 1.5. And if I look on the table here now, I've got one of these cells that I've broken open, and you can see here we've got the lithium ion core, which is a 14430 battery rented at 3.7 volts, and they're normally around about 750 milliamp hours. Ranges from 440 to 750 milliamp hours for these particular batteries. On the top of the unit you'll find here is a module which contains the battery management circuit to the charge and discharge parameters, and the buck converter to change from 3.7 down to 1.5. There's also some clever electronics in there that allows them to charge back from the positive terminal to charge the battery through this battery management circuit. Now, it said that they have over voltage, over current protection. I'm not actually cut one of these in two yet to find out what that circuitry is. They do run quite hot if you use them at 1 or 1.5 amps, so they do tend to run quite warm. Now, if you're going to be using the batteries in something like a torch, with a NiCad battery or an alkaline battery, you'll notice the brightness decreases over time and you then know when to replace a battery. If you replace them with the lithium AA batteries, you'll find that you get a constant light output up to the point where the battery management system shuts off that lithium ion core, and obviously then you lose the 1.5 and your torch just goes out. There's no warning, it just goes out. To try and use the batteries in any other equipment, you can use them in sort of mouse or keyboards, but I found they will not work in things like these flash units. They power up and show you that you've got a full battery, but when you discharge it once, that battery doesn't seem to want to come back up to the 1.5 output. So it looks as though they can't provide a high current pulse, especially with these flash units. They just don't work. There might be other equipment that, again, they will not work in. And some people say they don't work in blink doorbells or blink cameras. I've not blink cameras, so I can't test that, but there are some indications that they are not universally acceptable in all products. One of the other problems with these batteries is the buck converter. The buck converter is a switch mode device which converts the 3.7 lithium battery down to the 1.5 terminal voltage. Now, that's a high frequency switching circuit, and the harmonics of that can give you RF interference in things like radios and audio devices. So if they've got three of these in a pocket radio, you'll probably find that you lose the AM reception from it and experience noise. So they're not good in any situation where you've got sensitivity to RF interference. So again, radios will probably be out. I haven't tried these in any of my radio transmitters, but I will do that in due course. The other problem you have is the fact that you haven't got a battery management system that gives you a real-time output. So you can't put these in a device like a camera and observe the level of charge from, say, 75%, 50%, 25%. These will just work up to the point where the battery management system cuts off, and then the camera will cut down with no warning. So if you are using these in a disposable camera or a camera which takes to AA or AAA batteries, then you'll find that the camera will work fine and then just shut off, and you won't have any warning that it's going to do that. So beware that if you are using these type of batteries in those devices, you get no warning that the battery is going to switch off. Now, the rated output of these devices is said to be 3000 milliwatt hours, and I've explained that equates to 2000 milliamp hours. Because this is a 3.7 device and it's converting down to 1.5, that circuit is operational all the time. So there is a very, very slight discharge. It's probably only a fraction of microamps, but obviously there will be a discharge. And it said that they'll last over a year and then drop down to about 80%. So that's sort of a negligible discharge for these lithium type batteries. Now, to achieve the output of 2000 milliamp hours, you've got to use the 700 milliamp hours and 3.7 rating and convert that into the 1.5 with something like a 90% efficiency for these buck converters. So that's how you achieve something like 2000 milliamp hours from a 700 milliamp hour higher rated battery. You're getting the efficiency there. They're fine in things like torches. You get a much longer stable output, and other devices where you need high current, say in model cars, things like that, they're going to be ideal. But in terms of inbuilt power supplies for cameras, microphones, audio recording devices, I don't think they're going to be of any use. So I'll be using these only in my pocket torches and other standby equipment, which probably will benefit from the 1.5 volts over a longer period of time. But obviously you don't want to be using these in things like smoke detectors or carbon monoxide detectors, because they could just cut out and you'll have no indication that they have done so. Now, a word about these chargers. They are a dedicated charger. They're only for these 1.5 volt AA lithium ion batteries or lithium polymer. You can see on the device, you've got LEDs which indicate the charge status. At the moment, both of these are red, which means that these devices are charging. When they're fully charged, these will turn to a solid green. So you can see the charge. The charge circuit is rather strange because the device has to monitor what the terminal voltage is and then apply a charging voltage to bring the lithium ion core up to the 3.7 or nominal 4.2 that you'll find for these charging. So if I just bring my meter in here, let's just have a look at the charging voltage. So if I can get from the bottom of the terminal, you can see we've got a strange charging situation where we have, you can see we have a strange charging situation. We have something like a 4.6 charge down to 1.5, and then it rises back up to 4.6. So I guess this is the battery management system applying the 4 volts so it can pass through and charge the lithium ion battery. Then it switches off to monitor the output voltage, I guess. I'm not sure what the charge circuit will be. If I'm brave enough, I'll take one of these devices apart and have a look at the circuitry, reverse engineer that and just see what's going on in there. But the back of the unit says the charge voltage is 1.5, but that's clearly not right. You are seeing that 4.6, so that that passes through to charge the lithium ion core battery in the device itself. So a rather strange charging circuit, and that's why you can't use these in a standard charger, and you can't charge other batteries in this because of the way that this battery management system operates. So there we are, those are the new lithium ion rechargeable AA and AAA batteries. I say they're probably great in things like torches where you get a constant output, your light doesn't change, and in other devices where you might want to have constant output for, say, like model cars, etc. But for cameras, audio equipment, I guess that they're not going to be fit for purpose. If you've got any comments you want to make in the video description below, please do so, and I'll try and respond to those in due course. If you've not seen my photographic blog, which contains lots more information on Panasonic NiMh bridge cameras, photography in general, and some of the more scientific aspects of photography, I'll put a link to that in the video description below. You can have a look. And on the download page, there's an application form so you can join my newsletter group, and that gives me the authority under GDPR rules so that you can receive my email newsletter, which goes out every 6 weeks or so to my users. And it's more than a newsletter, it's a technical publication in many respects. Some of the things that I don't publish on the blog that have interested me over the last 6 weeks or so. So have a look at that if you've not already subscribed. So until the next video, thanks very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you do like and share the video, that would be even more fantastic. And if you are a new viewer, please do hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon. And so until the next video, thanks again for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.